I think growing up in a community gave me the power, the strength to be on these remote places and also to connect with local people. That is very important to work in conservation. My name is Ruthmery Wayqecha. I'm a Peruvian wildlife biologist. I'm currently working as the Andean Bear program lead. Conservación Amazónica acá en Peru. Wayqecha is a biological station. It's a Quechua name that means little brother, no? Because this property was bought from communities and we are neighbor to Manu National Park. So the people, communities, Manu are all our friends, our little brother. That's how the name came up. Wayqecha was established in 2001. And it belongs to the NGO Conservación Amazónica acá, Peru. Acá has three main biological stations, and they are located strategically across the altitudinal gradients. We can stay at 4,000 meters, and in 3 hours, you will be at 500 meters. So it's the perfect laboratory to study climate change, no? First, to see how biodiversity is distributed across the gradient, and then how this biodiversity is going to respond to climate change. So specifically, Wayqecha is in the middle of the cloud forest. No, we are covering clouds most of the time. As we are in the Andes, all the evapotranspiration coming from the Atlantic Ocean, from the rainforest, everything condensate and form the clouds, and the wind, they push to this part of the Andes. And it's in this part where the trees, as you see around, they are covered in mosses, epiphytes, orchids. All these array of epiphytes absorb the humidity, the moisture, and then they release little by little this moisture into water, to the streams. The streams will make the river. And finally, they're going to get into the Amazon River. So it's a very important ecosystem, and it's also a very fragile ecosystem, no? As right now, we have pressure from climate change from the lower part, and then we have the agriculture, fires on the top part. There are many endemic species that need this kind of environment. Within this species, we have the Andean bear, for example, and other species, as many species of orchid. That's the perfect place for the orchid because they need this moisture, no, for them to survive. Wayqecha hosts different researchers from different parts of the world studying different things related to climate change. One of the long-term projects is from Dr. Daniel Mezcal from a Swedish university called UMEA, where they sell these cloud exclusion curtains. And the idea is to see what is going to be the effect of the exclusion of the cloud. Because the idea is when the temperature increases, the formation of the clouds are going to get higher. So this part of the forest will get without the clouds, and without the moisture. There is also many different equipment measuring temperature, rainfall, humidity, light exposure. So what they're trying to find out how the trees, how the plants, how the epiphytes are going to respond to this change. We can start feeling, you know, the effect of climate change. Climate change is real and it's happening now. You know, that's for real, but I think we shouldn't lose the hope. I think as human, we can still do things. And we show, you know, as we all work together, we can do many, many things, you know, but we need to work as a team. I grew up in a small town in the south of Cusco, in the high Andes, in a place called Peruro. My parents were farmers, and so I grew up surrounded by nature, and I was always curious why the ants are carrying the lead, why the birds are eating dust, and I like to travel. No? Any opportunity for me to go out and explore, this was for me. So I decided to study biology, you know? Although my parents want me to study medicine or to be engineer, no, it's kind of like the dream of the parents. But then they understand that it's my passion I'm doing for good, no, to protect our home, no, pretty much the forest and the wildlife, you know. I got some opportunities, some fellowship opportunities to travel to the lowland rainforest and cloud forest in the center of Peru. And there I've been working in the lowland Amazon rainforest for over 10 years, studying diversity of taxa, no? And I know how important are opportunities, no, especially in my case, no? I came coming from a village, studying in the local university, no? Very close to here, but we never get the chance or the opportunity to come to Manu National Park or these amazing places because it was just too expensive. But somebody put this advertisement to do volunteering internship in the Amazon, and I was able to join, and that was a big change for me, opened my mind, and that's helped me to make connections and work in conservation, you know? So I know how important are these, and that many students need these opportunities. My dream from a child was always to study Andean Bear. My grandmother used to tell me stories where they talk about the Ukukus. We have these characters called Ukukus that are semi-god human bears, and they are the only ones that can climb the glaciers and bring back blocks of ice to the community as sacred water, for example. No? I was curious about them. Finally, I got the opportunity, a call in 2020 to study bears. I said, yes, that's my opportunity. That's why I'm here now. Bears, first, of course, are charismatic and flagship species. It's easy to attract the attention from government, from local people, no? Bears are threatened species, no? According to the IUCN, they are as vulnerable species. When you protect these bears, you can also protect other species under the umbrella. But most importantly, because they are the ecological role that they play as seed dispersers. No? So we also want to understand how potentially also climate change are going to affect these species, no? As they're a very important part of the ecosystem. We started as a project, no? Just trying first to find out where the bears are, no? Where they're located. And we know they are bears, but we don't exactly know where, in which part of the forest, how they're moving, what they're eating. So we decided with our collaborator, Andrew Whitworth, to set up an altitudinal transect where we can place camera traps every 50 meters of elevation, you know, across the whole gradient from 2,800 meters to 500 meters of elevation, no? But something I really love is the interaction between plant and animal, no? How these two important parts of the system interact. So I started growing as a team. I go work with botanists, and also we got a dog, you know, who helped us to find the bear scat. So in this way, we can understand better the diet of the bear, and also use this knowledge for our reforestation projects. We have a community work with the high Andean communities in the upper part of Manu National Park. where we have three nurseries and where we grow native tree species, but also we are trying to incorporate trees that are food for the bears. We're doing swimming ecology. For that, we place satellite collars on the bears. We have a team of bears, local guys, and us to do these captures, place this collar that has GPS, so then we can monitor the bears on real time. So that's helped us to understand better the movement patterns. The science part is to understand the secret life of the bears, no? And for that, we use different technologies to try to understand. So we're doing environmental lineage, also how our wildlife on these wild areas are with parasites, no? So as we are collecting bear scales, we are trying to also find out, no, what parasites they have in the natural environment and see this interaction coming from like domestic animals like the cows or the dogs. This information then will help us to build conservation strategies for the bears. Also, we do environmental education. Last year, we opened a bear interpretation center, and the idea is to bring school kids or any visitor, national, international visitor that can come here to the cloud forest and learn about the bear, the cloud forest, and the importance of this ecosystem. The vision I share with me, my colleague, our founder, Adrian Forsyth, Andy, is to have these places full of researchers. And not necessarily scientific researchers, so anybody, you know, who cares about nature and potentially becoming the next president or minister or anything like that. So unfortunately, a biological station start closing in different parts of the world. So we don't want that to happen because I think these places need to keep alive. You know? We have an internship program here. No, in my particular case, I have one for Andean women. No, a fellowship where we bring women students from different parts of Peru, and they stay here for 6 months. No, and the idea is for them to learn about basic skills on biodiversity sampling, monitoring, but also they receive training on statistics, first aid, and many other techniques. I would say women are more resilient. No. It's hard to find people who want to stay here for long periods of time, like a year, staying here without not much electricity, cell phone signal, and usually our women are keen to stay here for long periods. We also have another fellowship where we bring a mix, women and men, to stay here for six months. No? I think everybody needs an opportunity, both women and men, and we have the same skills. We need both, we are a team. What I like most here is to be in a family. You know, I always say to my team and others, like, I think the key for being successful and to work is to have a team. You know, a team means like everybody has different things to offer. We have people with different skills, and that's make possible what we do. You know, a team of local, national, and international people. You know, what I like here is to involve with local people. You know. Although they haven't been in university or maybe they didn't even finish school, but they have a lot of knowledge and I like them to be part of that for them to know what we are doing, no? Because this is also their home. If you want to conserve, doesn't mean you have to come here and work here like we're doing, no? I think you can from home, no? Even from the big cities, no? Being more conscious about what you're buying, no? Like many things are coming from deforesting the lowland Amazon. United States and other places, you still have forests, so protect them, no? Conserve these areas. There are still many things we can do with changing our behavior, but I think what we are losing now is the connection with nature. So whenever you have the opportunity, go out for a hike, for a walk to the forest, be part of nature, no? Feel the connection with nature, and that's going to, I think, help a lot. found these places, we still have love to lots of things to learn and to do, you know, for nature, for our conservation.